Welcome back, bros, and today we got ourselves gym battling in Pokemon Go. And I cover some of the most basic stuff in this video, along with some of the most advanced strategies within gyms, and there are actually some pretty cool tricks that you may not have heard of yet or seen. And we're gonna go over those in this video. Now, firstly, when you reach level 5, you can pick your team, of course, and you can go to a gym. Now, we are encountering here a Valor gym. I'm on Team Mystic. Since it's part of a different team, I'm gonna have to take it over and claim it in the name of Mystic and Articuno, the bird from the north. Now, in doing so, I'm gonna use my highest CP Pokemon to battle the gym, and I'm gonna use, obviously, a water type because he has a fire type in the gym. Always knowing the gym and the elements that you're going to be fighting up against is important because you can fit your squad with the right stuff. I can put a bunch of those Pokemon in there. In this case, there's only one Pokemon and it is Rapid Dash. So I might as well put Vaporeon in and let Vaporeon go against it because it's one of the strongest water types in the game. It has Water Gun, Hydro Pump, Aqua Tail, whatever. All three are amazing. And I'm sorry if I sound a little bit weird, I'm sick while trying to do this video, so I'm gonna try to commentate the next 8-9 minutes as much as I can and talk about all the strategies involved with this. So we're gonna knock out the Rapid Dash really quick, Aqua Tail when we can, of course, because of the buffs to the secondary moves. They're very, very good now, no matter what. Before, some of the primaries were just, it was better to never use your secondary, but nowadays, it's almost always good to use your secondary move. So we knocked the gym down to 2,000 prestige, or we knocked it down 2,000 prestige. It still has 500 left on it, so we gotta just fight it one more time really quick. Now you saw me use Vaporeon. Now I'm going to use a different Pokemon that's closer to the CP value of the Rapid Dash, and that is Seadra, because Seadra is still a decent water type. It has dragon moves, but mine has water here. And I'm going to take my water type and go up against their fire with just a little bit of a CP advantage. And you're going to notice that there is no difference in the amount of prestige or prestige that their gym loses. It's still 2,000. So it's still ineffective to use a lower CP Pokemon to fight. So you always want to use the highest CP Pokemon that you have. And that may sound obvious, but there are some really interesting strategies when it comes to training gyms that deals with the CP level of the Pokemon. So once you knock it down to zero, the gym will turn white, which means it is available to put a Pokemon in for any team. Any team can claim it. So I'm going to put a Pokemon in it and it will go blue. I'll probably just put in one of my big ones, but or bigger guys. Throwing Snorlax there. And then it goes blue in the name of Mystic. We now have this gym. Go us, right? Woo! Now I found another gym here, and this one is owned by the Mystic team, but I'm gonna add one of my Pokemon to it, or try to. I have to train it up a little bit. And for two reasons. Mainly so I can get a bigger reward when I cash out on how many gyms I'm a part of under the shop screen, but also because it will help reinforce this gym. And the higher level the gym, the more likely it is to hold on a little bit longer, stay around for a while. So an 8 or 9 Electabuzz is the first thing I have to fight. And then there's like some 1,900 Snorlax, I think. But I'm not going to go for the Snorlax because there's a few ways you can train. One of them is by killing, you know, both Pokemon in the gym, sure. But also, if you use a Pokemon that's relatively low CP or, you know, rated to the same CP level as the first Pokemon in the gym, that Electabuzz is 809, my Dugtrio is 827, ground against lightning, I have a little bit of an advantage here, then I'm able to train it up quicker because I can get more prestige. Unfortunately, my Dugtrio is above Electabuzz. Ideally, you'd like it to be below the Pokemon that you're fighting. So you're going to see here, I kill the Electabuzz with my Dugtrio, and it's barely higher. You know, it's like 15, 16 points higher. 18 points higher, I'm sorry. And then I want to go up against the Snorlax. I'm just going to leave right away. I'm not going to fight the Snorlax. Obviously, I can't win. It's a waste. So I'm going to get 250, 249 prestige for that. Now, in this next fight, I'm going to put up my big Vaporeon, and I'm going to go up against the Electabuzz and the Snorlax, and I'm going to clear them both. And while doing this, it will help me get a little bit of prestige, but it's mainly to show you guys the difference in prestige that you can attain based off of the level of Pokemon that you're using and how many Pokemon you're killing. Because not always does it matter the amount of Pokemon you're actually taking out when you're training a gym. It mainly deals with how you can manipulate how much prestige you get based off the CP values. I'm going to speed it up right here, sorry. The Snorlax is pretty tanky, so is my Vaporeon. It takes a while to get both of them down a little bit. Just know that I will win here in the end, and you're going to see the difference. I got 249 prestige just for taking out the Electabuzz with, we'll say, basically an equal Dugtrio, right? And when killing the Electabuzz and the Snorlax with my Vaporeon, you're going to see how much I get here. It's barely any different. I think it's about like 50 more, right? 290 something? Yeah, 294. So obviously that much of a time commitment to take out both isn't even worth it. But now that the gym is level 3, you can see up there, 3 Pokemon can now be in it. The gym level determines how many Pokemon can be in the gym. And you can see the XP on the left-hand side. I'll circle it. And then you can see the level of the person along with the person's name over on the right-hand side. Slovav is 19, for example. So I could add my Pokemon to it now. I'm going to add that in. And that way I can help reinforce the gym. Now you'll also notice that the gym just went up 2,000 XP. And that's because adding any Pokemon to the gym will automatically boost it up 2K XP. But that only works going up to level 3. At that point, you're going to have to train up. And then have to actually train like I am to add in a 4th, 5th, 6th to get the gym up to level 10, essentially. Now here's a 750 Bulbasaur up against the 809 Electabuzz. The Bulbasaur is a little bit better, so I'm able to take it out. The Electabuzz has a slight CP advantage, but look at the difference in prestige here once I knock it out. My Bulbasaur is Vine Whipping and Sludge. I tried to dodge that attack. It didn't work. We'll go over dodging in a little bit. There is a trick to it that people may not know about, but we're going to cover it. So I dropped the Electabuzz. I'm going to leave again on the Snorlax. I'm not going to fight the Snorlax. Very obvious. My 750 Bulbasaur will not beat that. But look at the prestige I gained. 539. So that's a way to level up gyms quickly. It's so easy. And a lot of people don't know that. It's a huge benefit having this information. So I'm with a friend right now. And I'm going to show you can actually battle with friends as well. You can't train with friends. So your training is separate. You have to do it by yourself. I mean, you can do it with a friend, but you can't fight together. When you're battling a gym, you can fight together. You'll see the 2 in the top left-hand corner. That number will actually go up based on how many people you're fighting with. And you can actually fight with members of other teams as well. For example, if we're fighting a Valor gym, I can fight the gym as our Mystic, and I can fight with Instinct players. But I'm not sure how many people that number can go to. The most I've seen is 7. I'm not sure if it goes over that. I'm not sure if it's infinite. It's something for you guys to test or maybe look up. But that is how you can tell you're fighting with a friend. Of course, remember the element types. I'm going up against Vaporeon. I'd rather take out my Flareon and throw in Victory Bell. Victory Bell has Razor Leaf, Solar Beam. Very good against Vaporeon. Super, super nice. But also, when you're switching Pokemon, look how far my bar is filled up right there. You want to use your special bar if you can. Because when you switch, when you take it out and put something else in, your special is lost. So if I was to bring out Victory Bell in a future fight in the same fight, like maybe after the Snorlax, there's another Vaporeon or a water Pokemon. I wanted to bring Victory Bell out. I'm going to try to dodge the Hyper Beam. Oh, dodge. There we go. I got it. So you can swipe left to right. Sorry, my voice is dying right now. Swipe left to right on the screen when its move is going to go off, and then you can hopefully get out of the way in time. But if I was going to use my Victory Bell again in the future, like I said, if I brought it back out, its special would no longer be full. It would be empty. So it's good to use your special whenever you can. Earthquake actually does not affect Gyarados that much. Even a dodged it, they're still amazing. You dodge things essentially when the light yellow flash appears on the edge of the screen. But it's only worth dodging like the big moves, you know? A lot of the smaller moves aren't worth your time dodging. You can probably do more damage than they will do to you, usually, okay? And after battles, you'll probably have to heal your Pokemon up and then fight with them again, most likely again. If you're fighting a big gym like this one is level 4, 5, 6, it can be difficult. So, we've talked about training gyms, we've talked about taking gyms, we've talked about taking gyms with friends. I'm going to show you a really cool trick here to train a gym up to level 10 very quickly. Once you've taken over a gym, put in a decently high level Magikarp. 160s, 170s, I'm going to put in a 200 because I have a 200. And then once you have a 200 Magikarp in the gym, you can fight it with relatively low level CP Pokemon because Magikarp does almost no damage. So I think we're going to use Weedle, but you can use, you know, a Pidgey, a Weedle. I'm going to use a pretty low CP as well, almost half the CP of the Magikarp. And by doing this, you can get a lot of gym prestige very quickly. The downside is that you do have a Magikarp in your gym. So it has its ups and downs. It's mostly if you have a lot of people with you and you want to train a gym very quickly, get it up to level 8, 9, 10, and it's a lot of high levels, so they have really good stuff to kind of counteract the Magikarp being there, then you can do this, and it's a very effective strategy to get a high-level gym quickly, and hopefully because it's higher level and you have a lot of big stuff in the gym, it'll hold on and stay yours longer. That's the essential benefit of it. So the Weedle is doing work to the Magikarp. The Magikarp's going to struggle. Get some damage in on the Weedle as well. But the Weedle's Poison Sting is victorious. I think it's Poison Sting. It might be Bug Bite. Either way, the Magikarp goes down 877 prestige. And last but not least, look at this. I was with a buddy, like I said. He put his Magikarp in as well. And I fought both Magikarp with my Weedle. and I took out both Magikarp with the Weedle, and look at how much you can get off of one fight, because each Pokemon you beat, essentially by doing this, you're going to get that 700-800 prestige. So I go back down to the Weedle, 114 is going to go up against a 178 Magikarp and a 200 Magikarp. Check this epic battle out. Epic CP battle. The highest of highest Pokemon, the scariest of the scariest, Magikarp versus Weedle. And Magikarp struggles, of course. Unfortunately, using Weedle special is essentially worthless. It's better just to auto attack the entire time. So I'm going to do that. Knock out the first Magikarp. There it goes. Bring out number two. I'm ready to do-si-do. Number two comes out. Weedle starts his grind in. He's going to take... How does Splash do damage, by the way? You notice that? Splash is supposed to do zero. My Weedle's taking damage from Splash. How does that happen? Just saying. He struggled me down. But my Poison Sting or my Bug Bite, whatever move I'm using, it's holding up. Will he do it? Oh! There we go. So the Weedle takes out both Magikarp. Look at this fucking prestige. Bam! 1,657. 50,000 prestige is needed to get to a level 10 gym, but you can see how this is super beneficial if you're leveling up a gym very quickly and you want to put a lot of people in them. I hope this explains a lot for the gyms. I hope it helps out. If you have any questions, of course, feel free to leave a comment. I will try to answer them. And yeah, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.